With any turbocharged engine, accurate and stable boost control is critical, and particularly as the power levels rise and traction is a bit of a problem, getting control of the boost becomes even more important again. Conventionally, boost control has been achieved with a pneumatic wastegate fitted to the exhaust manifold, and what this essentially does is bypass exhaust gas flow around the turbine wheel. By bypassing the exhaust gas around the turbine wheel, we're essentially removing the energy source from the turbo that actually creates turbine speed driving the compressor. Conventionally, this pneumatic wastegate is fitted with a spring, and this essentially sets the boost pressure at which the wastegate will start to open and start to bypass exhaust gas flow. We can still control the boost pressure itself by manipulating the pressure signal being sent to the wastegate. However, there is a limit there, and at some point the exhaust back pressure that's generated pre-turbocharger and pre-wastegate will start to work to force the wastegate off its seat, forcing it open. So what this means is essentially there is a limit in the range with a pneumatic wastegate between the minimum or spring pressure setting and the maximum boost we can achieve. Put some numbers around this. If we were running a 10 psi spring in our wastegate, we'd be unlikely to be able to reach between, let's say, 10 psi and 45 or 50 psi. This is definitely a big factor in traction limited vehicles. We see this as a big issue with drag cars, where the boost pressure that the car needs to leave the line with is significantly different to what it can use down in the deep end of the track, where it has a lot more traction available. A technology that is fast becoming more prominent is to do away with the pneumatic wastegate and instead run an electronic wastegate like Turbosmart's egate. Now, this technology isn't brand new, and OE manufacturers have been using electronic wastegates for some time. A lot of people have then taken the factory OE electronic wastegates and adapted those to an aftermarket application. One of the problems with some of the factory wastegates, however, is that essentially the exhaust manifold pressure can still force them open. Turbosmart's egate, on the other hand, is designed with this in mind and is capable of withstanding very high exhaust back pressures, up to as much as 120 psi, due to the design of the motor. Now, because there is no spring installed, this essentially gives us complete control over the wastegate position relative to our target boost pressure, and the position of the wastegate can also be logged at the same time. Now, there are some caveats with this though. The Turbosmart egate in particular does require quite large current handling capability in order to drive it open and close very quickly, as much as 20 amps, and this can be problematic for some of the aftermarket ECUs to control. There are of course ways around this as well. Now, if you are wondering about the two lines that we can see running to the wastegate in this particular application, no, that is not a pressure source. This is actually for cooling water flow through the wastegate. Obviously, the wastegate is always going to be located near to the turbocharger, and heat is an issue. So by circulating coolant through the wastegate, this can also help mitigate the effects of heat and keep that electronic wastegate alive.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.